answer that question. So I have approximately 12 to 15 questions that all of the candidates will be answering. They will have 2 minutes to answer those questions, no more than 2 minutes. Vicki has volunteered to help me in making sure that all the candidates answer within that time frame, because we do have a lot of questions. And one of the things that we want to make sure is that every question that the public asks is asked. It's vital that every voice be heard, and so we're going to make a strong attempt to go through all the questions. Note, however, that some of the questions are going to be somewhat similar. That gives the candidates an opportunity, if they had answered a question similar to that, it gives them an opportunity to expound upon their answer. So it gives you a little bit more time to respond to that. So forgive if you hear redundancy to some extent, but again, I think it's vital that everyone has an opportunity to ask a question that they're interested in hearing an answer to. We're going to begin before the questions. Number one is to make sure that all the candidates here are actually the candidates who are going to be on the ballot. That is vital.
Go up just a little bit. No, no, no. With the microphone, she's fine. But without the microphone, as long as you just up your voice just a little bit.
Okay. Very good. All right. So what I want to do is to go through the candidates. And I believe I know most of them at this point. But if I make an error, forgive me and just correct me. So, Leona Crichton is here, right next to me. She is running for a 3-year term, and that is one of 2 seats that are up at this time. Next to her is Dr. James Patterson, who is running for a 2-year term, correct? And next to James Patterson, Alpha? Charette? Okay. And Alpha is running for a 2-year term. And next to Alpha?
It's Roger Brown. And what I'm doing, I'm going to be giving Kelly Dillon's introduction tonight, because Kelly is coming back from Georgia. He's on vacation visiting his daughter, and he's about 3/4 of the way here. He called me and gave me permission to give his brief introduction.
Okay. So,
I will not be answering questions.
Thank you very much. Appreciate that. Yes, he can answer. He can do the introduction, but no questions answered. All right. Very good. Thank you very much for being here for Kelly. Next to Mr. Brown.
John Woodland.
John Woodland. And John is ready for a 2-year term. And then next is Carol Bildu. And she is ready for a 3-year term. And finally, on the end, is Garter Dahl Jr., who is also ready for a 3-year term. All right. Next on the agenda is a 1-minute introduction of each of the candidates. You can say whatever they want in 1 minute. After that, we will begin a round of questions. Okay, and I'm going to start first, this time around, with Mr. Garter Dahl, and we will work our way down the table, and then the round of questions will begin at Leona's end. All right. Any questions or comments on the the setup of this. Okay, for the introduction, you have 1 minute. Thank you.
My name is Garter Dahl. They call me Gar for short. And I was raised in Superior, graduated from high school there in 1964. And then I went on and got a bachelor's and master's degree in geological engineering from Butte, Montana, Montana School of Mines, now Montana Tech. Since that time, I've been in, I spent 20 years in the mining business, working in major capacities. And I had a number of multi-million-dollar projects during that time. In 1991, I set up my own international mining consultancy. I practiced, I'm still practicing, even though I retired to the Superior.
10 seconds.
And came back. So I'm very interested in community service, and that's why I'm running for the board.
Thank you very much. Carol?
Hi, I'm Carol Belladue. I was born and raised in Phillipsburg, and so I made it from Phillipsburg to Superior. And I've lived here for almost 43 years. I have been on the Board of Directors of the Chamber of Commerce. I've been on the Planning Board. I've been on the board of my church. I just was appointed to an unexpired term to the Hospital Board last summer, so I've only just been on the Hospital Board since last July or August. And I'm retired from First American Title Company, where I worked for 30 years here as the manager of the title company. And so I just wanted to get involved with the hospital because there's a lot of really exciting things going on. So that's why I'm running.
Thank you very much, Mr. Woodland.
I'm John Woodland. I'm the fire chief in the town of Superior. I have, by way of background, a Bachelor of Arts degree in American History and a Juris Doctorate degree, a law degree. Before retiring, I practiced law for 24 years, built and ran my own firm. After moving to Superior with my wife, we became involved quickly in things in the community. I think I've proven through my work with the fire department that I'm somebody that can get things done. In the 7 years that I've been there, we've constructed a new fire hall, brought in several grants, and brought in a new engine, etc. I've always been involved in community service, either as a volunteer firefighter or EMT, and also served my previous community as both a deputy mayor and as a school board member. So I look forward to doing the same for this community.
Thank you. Mr. Brown, if I could just have a moment here. A question was asked just a moment ago with regards to recordings.
Okay.
Does anyone have a particular issue?
If you have an issue with it being recorded, you do have the right to ask to not be recorded. It is public record anyway. It's just for record of this. Who are you representing right now?
I'm just part of the community. I work for the hospital. I'm a volunteer EMT. I'm on search and rescue.
Okay, and who requested the recording?
It was not a request, and I'd be happy to turn it off if anybody wants it off.
It's up to you, the candidates.
Yep, I have no problem.
I have no problem. That's why I always have to make some disclosures.
I have a problem with it because I forgot my makeup. Are we ready?
Yes.
Yes.
I'm Roger Brown. I'm speaking on behalf of Kelly Dillon. Kelly Dillon is a very modest, humble person. When you look at his resume, and you've all heard about the Band of Brothers, the series done on the 101st Airborne, Kelly Dillon was a master sergeant 20-some years in the 101st Airborne. And that's the creme de la creme of the military. And I might mention that his leadership qualities are admired by not only his peers, but the officers that he served with. survival manual. And right now, somewhere in this world, there could be a squad of 101st Airborne infilling into a dangerous area to save Americans, and we might not even know about it. That's the type of leadership that Kelly Dillon offers. And secondly, that's been recognized because Kelly Dillon is on the city council, and he was responsible, along with John here, for getting the new fire department built. Kelly Dillon is a listener. Kelly Dillon will serve this community well. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Brown.
My name is Alpha Charette. I'm interested in this community. I'm interested for its betterment in every way, shape, and form. I was instrumental in helping the city get out of the floodplain with information that I had acquired around 2001. I also helped to stop the Medicaid Advantage with Humana. They were not handling it properly, and I went to that and I stopped them in the state of Montana. I lived in Mineral County since 48 to 53, and from 99 to 2013. I think that we had a business background. And we had a business background. We had a courier service. We also started a business in Superior with snowmobiles. And I thank you for coming.
Thank you very much.
I'm James Patterson. Used to work at the hospital, also physician, so I think I'm qualified to be able to help lead the hospital and help the community out. I think it's important that we have a hospital here. My background also is in business and finance. I've got an extensive background in that and different jobs. I've only lived here a year, but very interested in living here full time and wish that I had been born here. So thank you for coming.
My name is Leon Crichton. I lived in Montana from 76 to 81 in Missoula, was a homeowner, and worked at St. Patrick's Hospital all that time. I came back in 2000 and lived in Roseau for a year, and then my mother and I built a house in town and have lived here ever since. 2 years ago, I opened this and that, a consignment shop in Superior. So I've kind of got the pulse of the community economy-wise. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I very much appreciate how you guys are trying hard to hit that 1 minute. In this case, this round, you may have 2 minutes. And I have in my hands all of the questions that I've received so far from everyone in the audience, or almost everyone in the audience, hopefully. Leona, you're going to be first. And Vicki is going to be monitoring the time at 2 minutes. And
1 minute. At 1:30.
So you can kind of watch her at the corner of your eye when she starts flagging to get an idea as to the time limitations. That way I'm not interrupting you. But you want to get ready at the time. All right, here we go. And keep in mind, the questions might be a variation of the question later on, but again, gives you an opportunity to expand or add to if you run out of time on the first question. All right. Why are you running for the hospital board? And what do you hope to accomplish?
I'm running for the hospital board. Probably I have been a patient of the clinic since I moved to Mineral County. And I had a very bad experience with my mother in the hospital. She was not properly taken care of. She went into dementia and had to have somebody with her full time until they could try and correct the issue. And that got me interested in what was going on there. I so I started going to the board meetings. I have questions. The first time I let them answer them to the best of their ability. The second time they told me I was limited to 10 minutes by the bylaws. And the third time I went and asked the question, who was watching over the $650,000 innovations grant? Who was seeing where the money was going and how it was being taken care of? I was told that that wasn't a comment and I could not ask questions. If I wanted to ask questions, I could write them down and they would get back to me. That's when I decided to sign up for this. Thank you very much.
Since my employment ended with the hospital, I've learned a lot of things that concern me. Patients have come up to me, employees have come up to me, and feel that they're not taken care of properly, that they're being lost in the shuffle, that we're going in a lot of different directions that we don't need to go in, and we need to be focusing on primarily on patient care. We need to worry about the people in this community and not be worried about the rest of the world, per se. We need to focus, number one, on the patients in this community, and number two, then we can worry about other things. But I am concerned with the direction the hospital is going. And again, all this is after I ended my employment at the hospital, but after talking to numerous patients, employees, I'm very concerned about the way the current direction of the hospital is going. That's it.
I would like to work on the board at the hospital because I feel like that I can bring some transparency. I want to know what's going on, and I think the people in Kenmore County want to know what's going on, and I'd like to see to it that they get the information as I get the information. I feel like that things have happened over there that have hurt this hospital. I don't want to lose this hospital, and I'm under the understanding that we've underwritten a loan Mineral County has, the commissioners have, and if something happens to that hospital, then Mineral County will be paying off that loan. Also, I feel like that I can deal with people on a reasonable basis. I had to do a lot of research for Humana, I had to do a lot of research for the flood situation, and I think I'm capable of doing that. I'm capable of digging until I get the answers. I feel like that we've had some business background. I am not the smartest person in the world, but I am intelligent, I think. And I would like to do Mineral County service. I'm really interested in this town. I'm interested in the adults, I'm interested in the kids. And I feel like that we need our hospital and we need a customer base, and everybody's running to Missoula. They don't want to go to the hospital. Why? That's what I want to find out, and I think we need to have a customer base to pay for this hospital. Thank you.
I'm running for a seat on the hospital board because I think I can contribute to make things better. Obviously, you just heard that there are a lot of concerns in the community, which ones are valid, which ones are not. I certainly can't tell you at this point, but I think my background, my legal education, and experience will certainly help me a great deal in getting to the bottom of them. I come in without a particular agenda. I have not going to sit here and say I've had a bad experience with the hospital. I haven't. By same token, I can say that seeing that there are a bunch of rumors out there, there are some things that need to be addressed. Whether it's purely a PR problem or whether the problems are deeper, I don't know. But I certainly think as a board member, I could get to the bottom of that. I think I've demonstrated in the past running the fire department that we have in the department made an effort to be right up front with the community with what we were doing. We passed a bond issue, we passed, built a new fire hall a few years back, because the community did know exactly what we were doing and supported it. I too think the hospital is extremely important. I certainly plan to live the rest of my life in Mineral County at this point, along with my wife. And that's going to be our primary source of care. That's the place we all go if there's an emergency. It's the place any of my firefighters go if there's an emergency. And as has been mentioned before, it is the source of some of the best paying jobs in Mineral County as well. So I think it's critically important. And I think I can help make it better.
When I was approached to be on the hospital board last summer, was actually quite shocked because I've never had anything to do with anything medical. I mean, the closest I come to my mother was a nurse, but I've never gotten involved with anything, even though all of the boards I've been on and the community service I've done, none of them had anything to do with the hospital or anything medical. And they said, that's great, because you come in with no hostilities, no agendas, no issues, you're just going to walk in the door and sit down and look at the facts and the figures and the information and be able to make sensible decisions and not have a lot of hidden agendas or hostilities that might affect decisions that you would make. So that's how I got on the board to begin with. And I can just tell you, when I first came in, most of our meetings have been 5 hours long. We've had a lot of issues to deal with. But every month now, more and more things are getting resolved and more things are getting worked out. And things are falling into place. And I'm telling you, this is an exciting time for the medical world and Mineral County. A lot of you people may have heard these things and think it's too good to be true for Mineral County, because that kind of stuff doesn't happen here, but there are a lot of really exciting, cutting-edge things that are happening here that's going to change this county and maybe even change the medical world to some extent. So I just would be proud to be part of it.
Thank you, Carol.
Well, like just about everybody up here in the front, I have also heard a tremendous number of rumors and innuendos and everything else about them. And from my experience, a lot of this is caused by not having clearly defined goals and objectives that are understood by the public. And one of the ways to get around that is to be appointed ombudsman to take questions from the public and get answers back to them. So that it's independent of the hospital staff and also independent of the board, to the extent that that can happen. Certainly there are a lot of legal issues that come into play on that as well. But I think an ombudsman would be a very good start on this. I personally have no agendas. I don't think I have to run in this thing. I'm very good at listening. And as an engineer, I'm taught to solve things, listen, define what the problems are, and then solutions, and then follow up and make sure that you do it. And to some degree, I think this has been one of the problems that has happened, is there's a lot of internal communication between the board and the hospital staff, but a lot of that does not go out in the community, and we need to focus on that. So I guess that's the main reason I'm running, is I've been back in Superior now for 7 years, and I really want to make a difference in how this community works, thrives, and grows. And we certainly need the hospital. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Go ahead and just hang on to the microphone. You're going to start with the second round, and the question is, what does a hospital board do?
The purpose of the board is to give direction to the staff, the hospital staff, and also to help set goals and objectives. And certainly, I've sat in on a couple of the board's meetings here the last couple of weeks. As Carol said, they can be fairly long-winded, and there's an awful lot of information that's conveyed back and forth. But some of it's just absolutely beaten to death. That's part of what happens when you have a number of people working. As far as the purpose of the board, it's to give the proper direction and also to make sure that there's a follow-through. Part of that is, you know, managing or overseeing what's happening on the budgeting side. What's been budgeted, what's been accomplished, what's been spent, and make sure that the goals and objectives have been set really work. So, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, I guess with Clifford Case, who many of you know, lived here pretty much all his life, found out I had been appointed to the board. Next time he saw me, he went, "Oh, there's my boss." I didn't think of it in those terms at all, but the board really is an oversight for all of the administration and the staff of the hospital. And, we basically review and approve of pretty much everything that happens there. Hiring of the employees, they're really diligently working to get a USDA grant to or loan to build a new hospital, a very high-tech new hospital. They've gotten massive grants in the last couple of years. They're just now building on a little extension to the lab area because they got a grant from the Hemsley Foundation for a very high-tech digital MRI machine. And, that bid was just awarded yesterday. We voted on that. I had to call in from the community hospital because I have a brand new grandbaby. And, we oversee all of those types of things. So, it's pretty much an oversight of the whole working of the hospital and the health center. They run kind of everything past us, and as a democracy, if we did not approve of what they were doing, we have the power to vote against it. So it's very responsible.
Thank you, Carol.
And I certainly agree with what's been said so far. The board essentially makes the major policy decisions and has, quite frankly, a legal responsibility for the outcome of those decisions as well. And it's important when you serve on a board like this that you remember that. And as a board, the board is responsible for looking at how money's spent. It's responsible for seeing that it's spent in the right way. And Carol mentioned the USDA grant or loan that they're looking at. That same process recently, we used the USDA loan for our firewall as well. Looked at a bunch of different options, and that was the best one. But the board is the oversight, and we have the ability and the power as a board, not individuals, but as a board as a whole, to look into exactly how things are being managed and to make sure they're being managed properly.
Thanks, John.
I do have to agree with what has been said. The hospital's a business, and it has to be a stable business, and you have to try to keep that hospital in a financial balance. In order, if you had a business and you didn't keep yourself financially viable, you would be out of business, and we don't want that to happen here. This is the responsibility. It's a big responsibility. It's not an easy thing. They make all these decisions. The only difference
difference in being a business is it has to have compassion, because it is a hospital. And compassion has to be in some of the decisions that are made, too. And the employees, they are vital importance to that hospital. That hospital wouldn't run if there weren't good employees. And so they're responsible there to try to keep their employees happy and see to it that things are running without a lot of strife and conflict. If there's strife and conflict, we need to find out why. And I think the board is responsible for that. The board is responsible for keeping the community knowledgeable. I think the community is like everything else. Sometimes you're busy, but when it comes right down to it, you would like to know what's going on. And I think we would be responsible for doing that. And so I agree. There's a tremendous responsibility. If you get into all the aspects of what the business is, if you run business, I think possibly most of you have, you know what it is to run a business, and that's what that board has to do. And they have to get along, and they have to try to improve. And so.
Thank you, Alan.
I think the number one thing is that this is a hospital district. It's supported by taxpayers' money. The reason there's a vote this year is because of a lot of things that are come up that people are concerned about. So the number one thing that the board should do is represent the people and make sure that we're supplying everything that the people want and need. And then everything that everybody else has said kind of comes into play. But I think the number one thing is that being a hospital district, we represent the people. And that's why it's an employee position.
The bylaws say that the board should promote the availability of high-quality medical care to the residents of Mineral and adjacent counties and to non-residents requiring emergency services. I look at their budget. I was at the last board meeting last week. They're $410,799 in more. This is not the way to run business. They have all these lovely grants to build all these projects, like the $144,000 of the same, which is on the building that you have here. The grant built the building, but the hospital can't staff it more than 2 or 3 days a week with a physician. The information for the board, there's no transparency here. They keep such a tight rein on the information that they do release. I kept asking questions about the board and not getting any answers. I found out that you have to be sworn in to be a trustee, that there's supposed to be 3 trustees at all times. We were down to 1 when they asked Carol to fill in. But I don't think they told us you had to be sworn in to be a legal trustee. And the board is supposed to take care of the community, its patients. Thank you.
Thank you very much. That answer, second round, we've got the third question. And Leona, go ahead and you answer this. You start the question. Question is, can you make decisions that are best for the community and not for your own personal fulfillment? And you don't have to use up
I don't think it's surprising. I've worked at the hospital, and that matter was resolved in an amicable way at satisfaction of me and the hospital while I had left. I don't have any agenda except for representing the people and making sure the people that I've run around, the patients that I used to have, the people that I work with, and the people that I meet every day in this community, that the hospital's here, that it's run right, it's not shrouded in secrecy, that rules aren't made up on the fly, that things like the bylaws are given out when asked, or people give them out when asked instead of waiting a month. It's just a bunch of things that need to be done that are common sense, that I think would get rid of a lot of the rumors and a lot of the things. A lot of people go out of town for their care, and it's pretty sad. We have such a great facility up here, and I think that we need to look at that. But I just want to represent the people. You know, anybody's welcome to come to me if I do get elected, or I want to also represent the people that work at the hospital. I would like to have meetings with them to find out what they feel is a concern.
I certainly don't have an agenda. I don't have anything that being on the board would advantage me in a personal way. And I'm interested in it being an advantage for other people. And I agree. I've asked for information. I'm sitting here without some information that I needed. I kept asking for it, and I didn't get it. I got one email today. I finally got one email today. And I know people are busy. I grant you people are busy. But again, this is part of the board's responsibility. And I know that they have somebody that they can say, okay, get this and this and this together for this person and get it to them. And as far as having anything personal here for myself, if I got on the board, I think you all know that that's probably going to be a little stressful. So I don't know. You know, I'm doing it not for myself personally. I'm doing it because I can be a help to this hospital. I like to see all of our places that we have with supplies. We came down here. Roy had to come down here. He had a very bad nosebleed that wouldn't quit. They finally sent him down to see Dr. Bruce. And while we were there, Dr. Bruce couldn't treat him like he wanted to because they were shifting equipment back and forth, and what he needed was in Superior. I'd like to see that all happen. I'd like to see if we're going to have a clinic here, it's fully staffed, and if we're going to have a hospital in Missoula, or in Missoula, but in Superior, that it has what it needs. And so, no, I don't think I would do anything for my personal pain.
I think I've proven over and over again that I'm willing to put my community ahead of my personal needs. I do have a personal need in the sense that I expect this hospital is going to be my source of health care. In that sense, they match. But during the time I was practicing law, I gave up hundreds of hours and thousands of dollars to walk out the door to answer EMS calls on a volunteer basis. In Superior, I decided that we needed a command vehicle, and we weren't in a position to buy one, so my personal vehicle serves as the command vehicle for no compensation. I again and again put getting the job done ahead of my personal needs. I think the whole fire hall project proves that I look carefully at what the community needed, what was right for the community, what the community wanted. Worked very hard to get the project to a budget point where it would work. And for those of you who don't know, the project was conceived, put together, and designed in such a way that town hall can be added on the end, and the town can get out of paying rent over and over again, and it's probably going to
The only concept I can see of personal fulfillment on this hard, tough job of being on the hospital board is that you could accomplish the goals that they've set. To acquire the loan from the USDA and build a new building would be just an extraordinary situation for Mineral County, and certainly would raise the level of the health care and the technology that would be available here. It would just make no sense at all not to have your health care done in Mineral County instead of going anywhere else. It's just not the board position that if you're looking for some kind of fulfillment for yourself or to gain something for yourself, it's just not the place you should be, because that's just not part of what the situation is there. We're just trying to improve healthcare in every way we can in this county. And one of the things I'm most excited about that has happened even since I've been on the board, they've been really diligent about getting out surveys to people who have come into the hospital emergency room, had treatment, and if they are not satisfied, there's now diligent follow-up, and they're actively making changes to improve every aspect of that if anyone has any complaints about how it happened, why it happened, and make sure that it's a bad situation, it doesn't happen again. That's one of my personal goals, is to make sure that all is improved, so.
Thank you.
I echo the sentiments of everybody that's spoken up here about there's no way I could see any way of making personal gains from work running on the board. It's a community service type involvement. I think it speaks highly of all of us up here that are willing to take on the responsibilities of being on the board, because it's a public service. It's not a place for personal gain. And part of that is we need to have a board that's diverse enough to be able to present different ideas, but can work closely enough together to be able to make things happen, give good direction to the hospital staff, and communicate well with the community. And I think that's really what's incumbent upon anyone that you elect to this position. Thank you.
Great. Thank you so very much. going on to that, here's the next question. And for those of you who are currently on the board, we'd still like you to answer this question. Just tweak it so it's one that you can answer, okay? What can you do for the board that the current board members are not doing?
Well, there are some gaps in the board at present. So somebody's got to fill those gaps, that's part of it. The other part is I can't address that question directly because I've only participated in two board meetings. But what I have seen is that there tends to be a situation where a lot of the board meetings tend to drag on for innumerable minutes beyond where they should. And that's caused by two things. One is a lack of focus on the agenda, and the other thing I think is probably trying to cover too much at one time. And by doing that, you end up kind of diffusing your efforts as you go forward. So I would like to see that tightened up a little bit. And then in addition to that, as Carol had mentioned there, the follow-up for care, questionnaires is a great idea. I think the board also needs to get a little better understanding of how the hospital staff function. And to that end, the board is possibility of having one or two of the board members fall around in different, different areas to see how the different parts of the hospital work. I think that's a great idea. Thank you.
Thanks.
The thing I think that has changed just since I've been on the board, since last summer, is that we're all getting more involved, truly involved with all the aspects of the administration. And we did decide at the last board meeting that we were going to kind of go into different departments, take turns going into different departments, not staying in one department all day, but branching out and just spending an hour or two in, you know, like Clifford with the finances, or Stacy Barros as the human resources, or even in radiology and lab, and, to really, really see on a day-to-day basis how things are done and why things are done, so we can even understand it better than we have in the past. So it's just a constant evolvement. It's not like the board has been run like this and no changes are being made. That's what it's been done and that's what it's going to continue. They have evolved so much just since I've been on the board. It's just really impressive. So I just see positive changes coming every month. And you're welcome to come to our meetings. They're open to the public.
Thanks, sir.
I think one of the things that comes out over and over again, there's been the discussions tonight about the rumors, and I think one of the things I can push as a board member would be more public communication. We do that with the fire department. There's a quarterly newsletter that the town sends out that includes something from the fire department every time. I periodically will get articles in the newspaper about what we're doing. When we did our fire hall project, we made a big effort, and not just in the week or two ahead of the vote, but years ahead, to keep the public informed of exactly what we're doing. I know and see and understand the absolute importance of doing that. Additionally, to the extent that there are rumors out there that require answers, I think my particular training and skills will help me get to the bottom of issues and make sure that those issues get brought out and are made public. I'm trained to read between the lines, whether I'm looking at an audit or anything else, and I think I can make sure that the community is comfortable that it does know in full what's going on.
Thanks, John.
Thank you.
Mr. Brown.
One of the things that I think that I could do is to help facilitate maybe meetings. That if we could have a pre-look at what the agenda was going to be for the meetings, that each board member could be somewhat prepared. I, like John, I think transparency and putting to rest rumors and not just glossing them over, I think I could help do that. I think I could be get along with the other board members. I think I could be a good part of the team, but not to the point of being a yes person for anybody. I look at issues and I have a disagreement, even if I have been in agreement with others right along, and I come to where I see it isn't what I think it should be, I won't agree with it. But I am not going to stand up and create an argument or call somebody names or things like that. This would be a new venture for me, but I've been in other areas where I've had to deal, where you're all dealing together and having to get along together, and I think I can be a really good addition. I've done things in town, I've talked to the different people who are running for office and ask them questions. You can ask Gordon. I pretty much get down to the bottom of things, and so I think I can be a real good asset on that board.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Brown?
question, what can you do for the board that's currently not being done? I think make them accountable for things that they're doing. The grants, the hospital being in debt, all this, you know, that I found out after I was an employee, that, you know, they're one point, they leveraged the hospital and the land $1.2 million loan, and nothing was explained to the community. Posting the minutes of the meeting like they're supposed to be at the courthouse. And everything that they've said, too. I also think that something that I'm not aware of the board has done is meet with the employees in an open atmosphere that they're able to talk and tell us what's going on. Because they're the ground troops. They know what's going on and what the problems are. And listening to them.
Thanks, James.
As I said before, I would like to see transparency. The minutes of the hospital meetings are supposed to be filed at the court, county courthouse, so they are available at all times for public perusal. The current board has never done this, ever. They talk about the board evolving. They're evolving now, but I feel it's because the government says if you don't do this, we're not going to pay you. If you don't do these client surveys, so we can punch it into our facts and figures, we're not going to pay you all the time. If you have a patient that comes back within 30 days for whatever they were in for, they're going to cut not only that patient's money, but all the other patients in the hospital. I really want to have a board that is accountable and knows what's going on.
Thank you very much. I'm going to do a very quick pulse check here because I know personally that even though I can be very interested in what's going on in the front, sometimes it helps to clear the brain. If you guys need at least a minute to stand up and decide. Now that he's a candidate, because this is a lot of brain work that you do, it means I need a little bit of rest. About a minute or so to stretch, walk around, get a drink of water. Yes.
I'm going to see.
with our dad, she had about 6 days old. We made some really good cheese. Her perfect friend.
They're worded a little bit differently, but there's still a little bit of a repetition of questions. And what I want you to think about is what you have brought up before and what you can add to it as succinctly as possible if you feel the need. All right? Okay. So, Leona?
Personnel office.